praise shall continually be in my mouth. Let us bless the Lord today. He is worthy to be praised. We're going to have our welcome by one of our ushers, followed by the praise God from whom all blessings flow. And then you'll see me again with a call to worship. Amen. Good morning. Welcome to the virtual worship of Mount Zion African Methodist Episcopal Church. My name is Keisha Stokes, and I'm a member of the Minnie J. O'Neill Usher Ministry. During this time of quietness, we have a place for you to be a part of our virtual ministry. As a virtual visitor, we pray that the Holy Spirit will connect as your spiritual source. The Word of God will guide your daily devotion and know with blessed assurance, with the Lord as your shepherd, you'll have everything that you need. Enjoy the quietness. Our call to worship. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of our Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. For a day in thy courts is better than 1,000. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of wickedness. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good. Those that be planted into the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Blessed are they that dwell in thy house. Lord, I have loved thy habitation, the place where thy honor dwells. For the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. O sing unto the Lord new songs, for he has done marvelous things. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. All the earth sing his praise. And at this time we will sing Yield Not to Temptation in your hymnals, hymn number 413. Thank you. Thank you. this time we will have our invitation, prayer of invitation by Brother Ben Broxton.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Saints, let us go to the Lord in prayer. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we have come today just to say thank you. Thank you, Holy Father, for all the things that you've done for us. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us all these years and through the centuries, Holy Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Jesus, through your Son Jesus Christ, we come asking you to please continue to bless us. Bless those things that we've done and to bless the things that we have not done, but we are desirous to do, Holy Father. Dear Lord, continue to bless us. Hold us in the hollow of thine own hand. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, because mercy suits our case, Holy Father. Dear Lord, we thank you for the grace that you've given us so graciously. Lord, bless this world. It's in a complete turmoil, Holy Father. Complete turmoil. Turn it back right side up, for you and only you can do it, Holy Father. Bless all that live within this nation. Bless the nation. Look down upon the people there. Help them to be good leaders, Holy Father. Let us be good followers. Holy Father, bless those that are sick among us. Bless those that are bereaved among us, Holy Father. Bless the prison bound. Let them know that thou art God, and beside thee there is none other. Bless those that are on the street corners, Holy Father. Lord, bless people everywhere. And dear Lord, please take care of the children. Have mercy on them. Have mercy on them is my prayer. Take care of them, for they are our future. They are watching us, Holy Father. Let us be good leaders. Let us be good leaders, Holy Father. Bless the saints everywhere. Bless Mount Zion in a holy and righteous way. And dear Lord, don't forget our shepherd and his family that leads this flock in a heavenly and gracious way, Holy Father. You sent us a good leader, Holy Father. Let us be good followers. Let our ears be open to hear. Our eyes be open. Our minds open to receive. And dear Lord, fix our heart. Yeah, give us a clean heart, Holy Father. Lord, we thank you. We thank you now, Lord. Bless those that are under the sound of my voice everywhere, dear Lord. Lord, look upon the sick that are among us and this virus that's running rampant, Holy Father. You and only you can fix it. And we say, in the words of Jeremiah, for those that are sick, heal and they shall be healed, for thou art our praise. Heal, O Lord, and they shall be healed, for thou art our praise. Bless all that are under the sound of my voice, we pray. Now, Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may hereafter serve and please thee in the newness of life to the honor and glory of thy name. Let us be good missionaries, as you were the first missionary, Holy Father, the greatest missionary there is. Through Jesus Christ, we pray. All of these blessings we ask. Amen, amen, and amen.
Now it's time for our scripture reading. Turn with me, if you would, in your Bibles to Psalm 33, verses 20 through 22. That's Psalms 33, verses 20 through 22. Our soul waiteth for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. For our heart shall rejoice in him, because we have trusted in his holy name. Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us, according as we hope in thee. Now turn with me to Romans 15th chapter, verses 10 through 13. That's Romans 15th chapter, verses 10 through 13. It reads thusly. And again, he saith, rejoice, ye Gentiles, with his people. And again, let the praise the Lord, all ye Gentiles, and Lord him, all ye people. And again, Isaiah said, there shall be a root of Jesse, and he that shall rise to reign over the Gentiles, and him shall the Gentiles trust. Now, the God of hope, fill you with all joy and peace in believing, that ye may rebound in hope through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. From all that dwells. And the Decalogue. And he said to them, ye shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets.
Twinkling lights and candles everywhere remind us that Jesus is the light of the world, that came to dispel the darkness. That theme of light, which is what originally gave birth to the Advent wreath hundreds of years ago in Lutheran Germany. And it's become a beloved tradition in many churches and homes. The Advent wreath is typically an evergreen wreath containing five candles, each lit on successive Sundays during the Advent readings. Some variations of the Advent wreath include different colors to correspond to different themes, while others keep the candles a simple white. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light on those living in the land of deep darkness. A light has dawned, for to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. and he will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign over David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. The candle of hope. At this time, we have the opportunity to pray. In God's word, he says for us to pray ye for one another. So wherever you are, just take this time to let us go boldly to the throne of grace that we might receive mercy and grace in time of need. Our Heavenly Father, we come to you, Lord, thanking you and praising you. We humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God in the name of Jesus. And Lord, you said in your word that we could cast all our cares upon you. So Lord, we just want to lift up all of those, Lord, who are hurting all over the world. You know every situation, and you're able. Then, Lord, we want to lift up all the sick and shut in Mount Zion, but not only Mount Zion, Lord, everywhere. For truly, man treats, but you're our healer. Touch, Lord, as only you can. For whatever the situation is, Lord, it may be an emotional, it may be a physical, a financial. It does not matter. You're able. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that we can call on your name. And now we're calling on your name, asking you to touch lives, touch families, touch our children. Just do touch, Lord. Just touch as only you can. Touch in a way, Lord. Let your presence be known, Lord. Touch those, Lord, that have heard of you but have not responded to your call. Touch, Lord. Touch. We thank you for your touch. And keep on touching, Lord, as we keep on praying and praising your holy name. This we pray in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Good morning. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. It is with great pleasure that I give honor to my pastor, Reverend Wendell Webster, and our First Lady, Sister Sheila Webster, Reverend Willie Branch Jr., Apostle Francis Larry, Rashad Bryant, the Mary Lever Missionaries, my Mount Zion family, and all who are connecting with us today by whatever means. We serve an awesome God. To God be the glory. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for every good and perfect gift comes from you. Have thine own way, Lord. You're the potter and I'm the clay. And this I pray in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Our scriptures reading from the New International Version, the Old Testament, Psalm 33, verses 20 through 22. We wait in hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. In him our hearts rejoice, for we trust in his holy name. May your unfailing love be with us, Lord, even as we put our hope in you. Our New Testament scripture, Romans, the 15th chapter and the 13th verse. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. After hearing these scriptures, for our subject, think with me on these words: hope in Jesus. Hope in Jesus. In Psalm 33, in this hymn of praise, the people of God remind themselves of reasons why God is to be worshiped and honored. God is good. He's the creator. He rules over all the nations, and he's the strength and life of his people. But most of all, they realize that by honoring God's rule and authority, they could have hope, more hope than they could even imagine. In Romans, the 15th chapter and the 13th verse, our Lord and Savior is our hope. We can only find real hope in Jesus. Jesus is the promise given and the promise kept. When we look for hope in other things and people, it becomes wants and wishes. It is necessary for as believers in Christ to keep our hope. That is why the enemy Satan tries to destroy our hope in Jesus. He tries to come and take our hope away. And when hope fades, we lose heart and doubt begins to grow. We get weak in our faith and we become discouraged and we feel abandoned. But we must keep our hope. So many things are happening in our lives today, from our world to our very own home. But we, as believers in Christ, must keep our hope so we can continue to be light in dark places. We, as believers, must keep our hope for generations now and generations to come. We, as believers, must keep our hope to continue to fight the good fight of faith. Hebrews, the 11th chapter and the first verse. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Another way of saying this is hope is the spoon that stirs our faith. When we have hope in Jesus, joy comes, peace comes. Looking back at Romans, the 15th chapter and the 13th verse, it says, "May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him so that you may overflow." In other words, an abundance of hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Hope brings joy. Joy is different than happy. We look at happy according to our circumstances. Now, don't get me wrong. There is nothing wrong with happy. Happy birthday and anniversary too. Happy days are good. But our joy comes from the Lord. The joy of the Lord is our strength. We don't look at what day it is. We look at who made the day. And hope brings peace. The Lord said, "My peace I give to you." The Lord's peace passeth all understanding and calms the storms in our lives. And the word doesn't say a little joy or a little peace, but an overflow. Hope in Jesus. Hope is expecting, but not just expecting, but expecting good. If we are not expecting good, we are not hoping in Jesus, because God is good. So when we hope in Jesus, we know the best is yet to come. Hope make us change our way of thinking. Hope make us change our way of talking. Hope make us change our way of acting, even though our circumstances have not changed. We keep hoping. The pain is still there, but hope says the best is yet to come. The bank account is still the same, but hope says the best is yet to come. The situation just haven't changed, but hope says the best is yet to come. Having hope in Jesus, we will say, "I'm going to wait until my change comes." Earlier in my message, I said what happens when hope fades. By now, I am sure we all realize that we need to keep our hope in Jesus alive. So where there was doubt, we now have faith. Where we were weak, we now are strong. Because greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. Where there was discouragement, we are now encouraged to wait on the Lord and be of good courage, and he will strengthen our hearts. And where there was a feeling of loss, we now know that Jesus said he'd never leave us, not forsake us. Hope in Jesus. In conclusion, let us keep our hope. How do we do that? by reminding ourselves over and over again of the promises of God and His faithfulness. As we start another Advent season, our hope represents preparation. Let every heart prepare him room, and anticipation and expectancy. In the midst of everything going around us, in the midst of everything sometimes happening in us, and yes, to us, hope in Jesus. I say hope in Jesus. I say hope in Jesus, because the best is yet to come. Ooh, hallelujah. At this time, we have an opportunity where we cannot let pass by. If there's anyone listening and you have not accepted Jesus as your personal Savior, this is the time. There's no better time than now. Or you may be looking for a church home. We invite you to come and be with us. If any one of these invitations, you can contact our church, our pastor, or any of us here at Mount Zion. And we will welcome you. We'll put our arms around you, and we'll pray with you and help you, and our pastor will do all he can, and all of us, to help you as you continue on your journey after you take that step of faith. So anyone, text, email, word of mouth, however, communicate, let us know. We are here, willing and waiting. As we know, we cannot beat God's giving. We truly can't. And some of our ways to connect by giving is our GiveLify, which is an app that you can receive on your phones. Or you could come by the church on Sundays from 9:30 until 11:30. And Wednesdays from 11 until 1. And it's always, the mail slot is always available to receive tithes and offerings. And let us not forget our monthly offerings, our special offerings, our pledges, our tithes and assessments. Our announcement. Let us remember our noonday prayer lifeline on Mondays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. Our Bible study, Tuesdays at 12 noon and 6 p.m. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Thank you. Thanks to all participants on program, and a very special thanks to Reverend Joyce Anderson for such a wonderful message. Hope in Jesus. Amen. I also want to thank Ms. Branch for leading the WMS this past year. You did a wonderful job. As many of you know, I've been elected president for WMS of Mount Zion. It is my desire to lead this organization in a way that will embrace love for all mankind. We encourage all women of Mount Zion to come be a part of WMS. I look forward working with everyone. And again, thanks, and have a wonderful, blessed week.
In the name of the Triune God, may the spirit of Christian mission enter every heart. And this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.